shepherds wanted to go and see the baby. When they arrived at the stable, they were filled with joy at seeing Jesus lying in the manger. They knelt down and worshiped him. They told Mary and Joseph how the angel had appeared in the sky and told them that Jesus was to be the Savior of the world.
Yeah, Ma. I'm coming to church. Man, I'm not gonna be late. You got them pies I like? I bet. Yeah, we gonna be there. I'll be there. Okay. Love you. I gotta go. Bye. Now, little man, remember I told you Christmas gonna be a little different this year. They've been going through some hard times, so. But you gotta trust me. Things gonna get better. We have to do Christmas next year, okay?
Is Mom coming back for Christmas?
Well, we have to wait and see, won't we?
Yes, and he's married, so he's not available. That's okay, Xavier. I'm married too. So your mom's here?
You asked a lot of questions.
I do, but it's because I wanted to get to know you better.
I can't say everything because you're a stranger.
Ooh! You are very smart. Do you have any brothers and sisters?
No, I don't. But I don't need any.
So your parents don't want any more kids?
I don't know, who else do?
Why are you so mean?
I'm not mean, it's just not anyone's business.
Okay, class, you know, he's right. It's not any of our business. Let's go ahead and get back to the lesson. Who could tell me the name of the angel that told Mary she was going to have a baby? Yes, Xavier?
Gabriel.
Very good.
I know all this stuff.
That's good. I'm sure that there are kids here that don't, though, and I want them to learn. You mind helping me with that?
Yes.
Good.
So if Jesus is Mary's son, how is he also God's son?
Well, Mary is actually a virgin, and Joseph wasn't his father on earth, but God is his father in heaven. And God gave Jesus to Mary.
Out of the mouths of babes.
Is he right?
Yes, Manny, he is correct.
And Gabriel was the angel that told Mary and Joseph that they were going to have a baby.
And that wasn't just any baby.
That's right. You guys are so good.
Why does there like stand in all this tree stuff? It's not even in the Bible.
It's not, but I think that's something that you should discuss with your parents.
That is not real.
How do you know? You haven't seen him.
Exactly, which proves he's not real.
That doesn't prove anything.
My dad buys me gifts and he told me that Santa's not real.
Well, that doesn't make any sense because I get presents from Santa that weren't there before.
Class, I think this is something that you need to discuss with your parents later, okay?
So Santa's not real?
No, he is not real, and you're a baby if you think he's real.
I think you need to come with me.
Are you gonna send my dad on me?
Let's not worry about that for now. I just need to talk to you. Okay, class, we're getting ready to go outside for a moment. Y'all behave, and I'll be right back, okay?
How do you get in trouble when you don't even go here?
So I guess I'm in trouble.
Well, I'm not sure. Well, what you did wasn't wrong. It was just out of line. You're very opinionated.
You like to talk a lot.
No, well, I just think you'd do better if you had an outlet, like someone to talk to.
I'm not talking to anybody.
Not even Jesus?
Not even Jesus. He lets bad things happen.
Huh? What do you mean?
You know, like God, Jesus? He lets all the good stuff happen, but he lets all the bad stuff happen, too. He let me get into a fight at school this week, or how my dad lost his job.
Your father lost his job?
I don't want to talk about it.
Are you sure? I'm sure it would make you feel better.
How would it make me feel better?
Well, you know, it's like when you talk to somebody and you get stuff off your chest.
You mean like praying?
Yeah, like praying. It's the best thing to do when you feel like you can't talk to anybody and you need some help with stuff.
That's what Granny said to me the other day.
Well, you know, if Granny says it, then you know I'm right.
So what do I say? Like I'm really, really mad?
You just tell Jesus the truth. You say, "Dear Jesus, I'm really, really mad. And I don't understand. And I know you can help me."
And then Jesus will fix it?
Yeah, he will. Now, it might not be right when you want. You have to be patient and have faith and believe.
So I got a lot of things to pray about.
Yeah, you do. Are you ready to go back to class now?
I guess, but can I still tell you the story about Jesus Christ?
Well, I thought you said it was a dumb kid story.
Yeah, but I was upset, but I can just pray about it.
Okay, let's go back to class.
That he was stealing out of the cash register.
No, you did not. That boy was raised right.
Huh. Sure he was. But he grew up, and you know how they act when they grow up?
Yeah, and I heard his wife then left him too. And that is a shame, because he got to take care of that son all by himself. I wonder if she left him because he ain't got no job.
Nope. She left him because he been smoking that weed. So she had to leave him, and he ain't no good now.
Now that boy was raised right. Yeah, he made some wrong turns. But now he got that little boy following in his footsteps.
That's a shame.
Hey, ladies.
Hey, happy baby.
Hi, how are you doing?
Fine, how are you? How's your wife?
And my wife's doing fine.
Okay, how are
you? Children fine.
We are presenting the celebration of the birth of Jesus through the eyes of the children. Zechariah 8:5 says, "The streets of the city shall be full of boys and girls playing in the streets thereof."
Baby Jesus is born. Baby Jesus is born. It's time to celebrate.
Why are we celebrating baby Jesus' birth?
Don't you remember in Sunday school about a Savior coming to earth to save his people from their sins?
How's a baby supposed to save people?
He won't immediately save anyone until he gets a little bit older and wiser. And the grace of God is upon him.
What?
Let me explain. It's like a gift that's already been given to you, that God already has for you. It's unique, and it's a perfect fit. And it's only given to you by Jesus Christ himself.
Well, how will we find baby Jesus?
We'll follow the star of the east.
Psalms 95:1 says, "O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation."
So this life's got you down, and you feel like there's nowhere to turn. Just looking for a friend that'll turn things around. He's the one that will be there when you feel like no one else cares. You just gotta have faith and turn that frown upside down. He's the beginning and the end, so that means he's indestructible.
He was born of this world, lived and died, but he was raised on Sunday morning.
And he knows what you've been through. If you believe in him, you're capable
to withstand whatever's in your way. He's the greatest gift on Christmas Day. This holiday, he's a reason.
This baby that we sing about, Jesus is not a baby anymore. He's a man. He's our God. He came to this earth to teach us. He bled and died for our sins. He didn't just come to earth for Christmas. He came for the day you took your first breath. He came for the day you took your first step. He also came for the day you committed your first sin. He came for the day when you hit rock bottom and you didn't know what to do. He came for the day when your best friend dies and you didn't know what you could do without him. He came for the last day of your life when you took your last breath. And he will be there when you make the decision of whether you will spend eternity with or without him. He's waiting for you. He's calling you to come and give your life to him. He's right there waiting for you. The door of the church is open.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
What are you waiting for? Go ahead, son. Don't fight it. You won't regret it.
What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to say?
Listen, you just tell Jesus the truth. You say, Jesus, I need you. I don't understand, but I know you understand. And I know you can help me to understand. Go on, son.
Yeah, she's right, Dad.
What? Church, so we can thank them. They got the tree, the presents, and they even helped me find a job. Man, who was this knock at the door? It's Christmas. Who is it? Mariana?
Hey, Sean. Can I come in?
I heard you come back.
You did?
Yes.
I did too.
Are you gonna stay for some breakfast?
Of course she will.
Smile. Close your eyes.
You can't tell people not to smile.
And action.
Mariana?
Hey, Sean, can I come in? Oh, thank you.
sorry, Jaden. When I said say it a little louder.
Hey, oh. Just give me the cheese.
No. I heard that he was stealing out the cash register.
Uh-oh. Bring her up. It's good.
She's
good.
She's so in it.
That's good. We can start from there. Steal it from the cash register. We'll start from there. And action.
Uh-oh. So Santa.
Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. So this is Hollywood right here. This is the part you don't see. Yeah, right.
All right.
Catch up for the crowd.
You got your
tissue.
Yeah. I'm just wiping with my hands.
Can we give a hand to this wonderful film crew? Yes. Yeah.
And then give a hand to yourself. Y'all did awesome.
Okay, y'all gonna have a bumper reel?
Yeah. Oh yeah, we got it. Don't worry. Thank you.